Recorded Books presents Jacob Riis's Camera, Bringing Light to Tenement Children, by Alexis O'Neill, illustrated by Gary Kelly. Read by Chris Henry Coffey. I hate darkness and dirt anywhere, and naturally want to let in the light. I love to mend and make crooked things straight. Jacob Riis. The power of fact is the mightiest lever of this or of any day. Jacob Riis. 12-year-old Jacob hated Rag Hall. The rest of Riba, Denmark, was filled with trim homes, sweet grass meadows, and fresh wind blowing from the sea. But Rag Hall was a rat-infested, ramshackle dwelling. As soon as he earned extra money, Jacob donated it to the poor in Rag Hall to help tidy things up. 15-year-old Jacob had a mind of his own. Although his schoolmaster father expected him to become a teacher, Jacob went to Copenhagen and became a carpenter. 21-year-old Jacob was determined and persistent. When the rich mill owner's daughter, Elizabeth, turned down his marriage proposal, Jacob sailed to America to earn his fortune and ask her again. But when Jacob arrived in New York in 1870, he discovered that jobs for immigrants were hard to find, hard to keep. Undaunted, Jacob scrambled to earn a living. Carpenter, coal miner, mule driver, muskrat hunter, field hand, salesman, and more. He took lessons to learn how to operate a telegraph machine, but he ran out of money before he finished the course. Often penniless, Jacob slept in abandoned barns, fields, and cemeteries, and in homeless shelters that were so filthy and disease-ridden, he vowed to put an end to them someday. One winter evening, Jacob sank down on some steps, weak with hunger, destitute, homesick for Denmark, lovesick over Elizabeth, and utterly alone. As luck would have it, the principal of his telegraph school walked by. Jacob explained his plight. The principal knew Jacob to be a bright young fellow, so he gave Jacob a note recommending him for a reporter's job at the New York News Association. To Jacob, reporting was a noble calling. Back in Denmark, Jacob had helped his father edit a newspaper. He admired how reporters made people's lives better through their stories. Before long, Jacob landed a job at the South Brooklyn News. He saw pushcart vendors being robbed, children laboring in sweatshops, homeless boys begging on the streets. Day after day, Jacob learned the business, first as a reporter, then as editor, and finally as owner of the newspaper. And through all this, his love for Elizabeth still burned. At last, Elizabeth agreed to marry him. Jacob sold the newspaper to pay for his voyage to Denmark for the wedding, and he and Elizabeth moved to New York. When their first son was about to be born, Jacob knew he needed to earn enough to support his growing family. Jacob landed a job as a police reporter, chasing down crime stories for the New York Tribune for the princely sum of $25 a week, and his life began to change. Jacob's office sat a few blocks from Mulberry Bend, New York City's worst slum, and right across from police headquarters. He often worked until 2 or even 4 o'clock in the morning. Then he would put on his hat, adjust his spectacles, and walk the whole foul length of Mulberry Street through Bandit's Roost, Bottle Alley, Baxter Street Alley, Rag Picker's Row, across 5 points, and down to Fulton Ferry on his way home to Brooklyn. What Jacob saw in those neighborhoods gripped his heart. Tenement buildings obscuring the skies, apartments jammed with immigrants, Slavs, Italians, Jews, Irish, Chinese, families toiling in stifling sweatshops, the stench of mold and kerosene choking the air, privies overflowing in courtyards, children without green places to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.